Everybody loves pasta, pasta, but how do you make pasta, huh? Today we're here with Gianluigi at Rusticheria d'Abruzzo to learn how to make an artisan pasta, a pasta that makes your belly happy.
Grazie Vincenzo, we explain today how to do the best pasta in the world.
You know, we go to the shops every day, we buy the pasta from the packet, you look at the pasta, you look at the price, but how is it made? Why is the price more expensive than the other one? What's inside the pasta? Acqua, semola, eggs, what's in there? Today we have Mr. Rusticheria d'Abruzzo, the man that makes one of the best pasta in the world, telling us, showing us how pasta is made. How do you make pasta? What ingredients do you use?
Yes, Vincenzo, we are in Italy, that is the number one producer of pasta and the number one consumer of pasta. We have 26 kilos per year and 5.5 million tons of pasta produced all year. We are the number one in the world about the production of pasta. Pasta is the simple product. It's very simple because only one ingredient, semola di grano duro, and is important in Italy because the law requests to put the name pasta di semola di grano duro only durum wheat. And the ingredient of durum wheat is the secret and the best thing to do the best pasta in the world, also in Italy.
So the semola, or in English they say semolina, it's something that it's the most important ingredient. So where do you get it from? What's the process, you know, to find this top quality semolina?
Yeah, first of all, Italy produces 70% of the durum wheat that we need for the whole production, and 30% we need to import because to cover the whole production of pasta. For us, the best way is to blend the grain and the semolina, to use 70-75% the grain from Italy and 25-30% the imported grain that we buy from Australia, from Canada and from North America. They are the three parts where the high protein grain wheat growing and that we can import to mix with Italian grain. Why both? 70% Italian grain because we need the taste. The Italian pasta is more tasting than the other product because the grain that grows in Italy is more flavor, more taste. And we use 30% for imported grain for the protein, for the tenacity, and for to be that the pasta is always al dente. Yeah, al dente means that is very strong, is the tenacity, is not like smooth and soft, like the other pasta available in other market except of Italy. Okay, not only semolina from the blend between imported and the local grain, but we produce also the 100% Italian grain for the particular variety of grain. Senatore Cappelli is the one of the old grain, and then also the semolina and grain from Abruzzo. The difference between the blend between imported local grain and the 100% from Abruzzo are two different products. In the classic line where we are the blend, the pasta is more strong, with more tenacity. In the local grain, we have more taste, more flavor, but less tenacity. We are in the semolina section and we start the production with the semolina in the tank. You see that now we put the semolina inside the tank, and after that the semolina goes on the press. This is the press where they join semolina and water together, and the dough works for between 12 and 15 minutes. That is the right time to form the gluten. That's why we have
one tank where arrived the semolina and water together, and after 20 minutes the dough goes in the screw before the dies. The process is very simple. Semolina, water, come in vacuum tank, goes in the screw and then in the dies.
Ok Gianluigi, allora, the impasto, we make the dough up there, the bronze die is here, the extruder, and where is the pasta?
The pasta before the pre-dryer is here.
Guys, here we have the fettuccine. Fettuccine, guarda che belle. You don't experience this every day, let me tell you. I'm very lucky to be here with Gianluigi. I can't touch it, but I wish I can. So Gianluigi, are they very soft now, the pasta?
Yeah, it's the soft now before the pre-dry. After 1.5 hours, become a little bit strong before to go in the cabin.
Okay. So can I eat the pasta the way it is now? Can I eat it? Gianluigi, I'm going back to my childhood, you know? I used to have raw pasta growing up. My grandmother used to make it. And now I'm here in an artisan laboratory eating raw pasta.
Is the same taste?
It's got more character.
Yeah, it's
because of the semola. Tastia. Nonna's pasta is very soft because it's egg pasta.
Yeah.
This is my lunch for today.
Yes, after 1.5 hours from the fresh pasta, in this pre-dryer we give the form in the spaghetto, and after we put on the trolley, we send to the cabin for the finish recipe of dry.
Hi guys, this is the room where you dry the spaghetti, yes. The pasta. You put the pasta in there and the pasta dries gently, slowly, so it's easier for you to digest and better for you to taste. Gianluigi, let's tell our friends again, why is the drying process so important to have a low?
Yeah, it's important to maintain the low temperature, because we need to maintain all characteristics of the semolina and the grain.
Yes.
We, with a low temperature, we maintain and we not caramelize the sugar.
We don't stress the...
It's no stress, yes. And not destroy the ingredient and the benefit of the wheat.
So that means that you can produce just enough pasta, you know, for your clients. You don't overproduce. You think of quality, so you take your time to produce the pasta.
Yes, of course, that we
instead of
the this machine that produces 350 kilos per hour, it means that we control the production,
yes.
And we continue to maintain the small batch to control the quality.
A quality, yes. Yeah. Beautiful. So the short pasta is a different drying
it's
process.
It's different because instead we have trolleys, we have a the pressure is too big.
Yeah, you need to train to do this job. Oh wow, okay, so what's the process here?
The process is the tray that we put the short pasta, and we keep for 24 hours for the short inside of the cabin.
Okay, so this is ready to go, ready to cook?
Yeah, it's ready to the recipe. Because smaller shape, small time, less time.
So today we learn that the short pasta takes less to dry, the longer pasta takes longer. Now what about cooking? Does the cooking of the short pasta is less than longer pasta?
Yeah, it depends for the thickness. For example, if you cook spaghettini, that is 7 minutes, and the size is 1.7 millimeter. If you cook spaghetti, it's 2 millimeters more, around 12, 11 millimeters.
So the thickness, not the length.
Not the length. The thickness is for the cooking time. This is the part after the dry cycle finish.
Right.
You know that the spaghetti is long, around more than 1 meter.
Yeah.
And to pack it, we need to cut.
Right.
This machine we use for to cut in 4 pieces. In between 1 meter is 4 for 25 centimeters that we can pack it in the package.
So what's happening now, Gianluigi? The spaghetti have been dried.
Yes, we finished the cycle after 30 hours, and now we are ready to cut and then to package it.
So 30 hours of drying process. I'm not going to touch it because I don't want to touch it, but this spaghetti have been drying for 30 hours. At what temperature?
Yeah, temperature between 42 and 46 degrees.
42 Celsius. Can you believe it? It's like the old school, you know, the way it should be done. Gianluigi, how do you control the quality here at Rustichella d'Abruzzo?
We control in 2 ways the quality. The first one is by the law that the humidity cannot to be up 12.5%, means that the water inside of the pasta after dried is around 12.5, but Rustichella usually is 11, 11.20, and I after when we cook pasta I show you why. And the second is this machine that we stress pasta inside, and if the pasta resists at this process we pack it, if not we remove
it again.
Yes, because it's important that pastas not breaks after the production.
This is the final stage. Beautiful packet, the pasta is finished, it goes inside this beautiful packet, Rustichella d'Abruzzo, and then it gets to your home and you can boil it and serve it with your favorite sauce. Surrounded by beautiful, beautiful pastas. Some of the pastas that you make.
Yes, Vincenzo, we produce more than 150 shapes of pasta.
And basically uncovered for every day of the year.
Yes, almost of them are original, regional source. 2 different pastas and 2 different colors. The first one is an industrial product that is more brown and smooth. And the artisanal is white and rough. The bronze dice is the first element to give the roughness to the artisanal product, but the industrial product or industrial pasta use the Teflon and plastic. That's why this is the rough and this is smooth. But the third element after semolina, bronze dye and dry system is the time of the dry and the temperature of the dry. In artisanal, we have a long process, around 30 hours until 56 hours. For example, the bucatini that we produce in Friday are ready in Monday, 2 days to dry. In industrial, we use the temperature up 85 degrees Celsius for 3-4 hours. But what happens when you put pasta in presence of 85 degrees and up? That pasta is almost carbohydrate, and carbohydrate is sugar, but when you put the sugar in presence of high temperature, all sugar become caramelized. This is the reason that the color of industrial pasta is brown, because inside all sugar you found caramelized, and pasta result more strong. In artisanal process, where we use more than 30 hours to dry the pasta, the color remain like the semolina color. We not destroyed any sugar. We maintain and we save the whole characteristic of the grain in pasta. And after you will see why on the plate happen between artisanal pasta and industrial pasta.
This is the moment of truth. We are cooking the cheap commercial pasta and we are cooking the artisan pasta. Come on, let's put them together in there and let's see which one is better. Let's see which one is tastier. What a privilege to cook with you.
Thank you very much.
So when you cook the pasta, you press it down. Water must boil. You put 1 tablespoon of salt, or even more if you like it salty. And then you push it down. So this pasta, the commercial pasta, needs about 7 minutes to cook.
Yeah, seven, eight.
Yours?
Is between 11 and 12. It depends if you like al dente, you wait 10 minutes. If you like perfect, 12 minutes.
We make it al dente. Let's see if it's tasty. Really al dente.
Bread, semolina.
Filling. But when you cook your pasta, does your pasta grow more than a commercial pasta? Yes. I noticed the growing.
We was in the factory and they show you about the humidity inside of pasta.
That's
that
right.
The minimum is 12.5 and rusticella is 11.2, means that we dry 10% more the our product, our pasta, and when you put in the water, this part drinks more water and grow much more. If you check 500 grams of pasta of rusticella before cooking and after is double. If you cook 500 grams, become 1 kilo.
So if I go to the shop and I buy a pasta for $1, like commercial pasta, I use 150 grams just for me. If I go and get rusticella, I need maybe 80 grams.
Yeah,
because and I get double.
They get more water, they're growing better, and the weight will be more.
All right, let's take this pasta out. Let's take the commercial pasta out. Let's see how the sauce reacts with this. A little bit of pasta water, just a little bit, to revive the sauce. Okay, so this is the industrial pasta. If you look at it, it doesn't look that bad, right? Because also we're not comparing this with anything else. A little bit of basilico. You can make a commercial pasta look good. Now let's compare the pasta with an artisan pasta. I can tell already the pasta grew so much. Get a little bit of pasta water. Let's revive the sauce. See, I can see already that the pasta grew a lot more. Look how smooth. Can you see any difference?
Yeah, you can see that at the bottom of the pan is not sauce, but all sauce are inside of pasta.
There is no dry sauce at the bottom. I mean, you mean that the pasta is absorbing the sauce? Is that what you're saying? It's absorbing all the sauce. Wow. So the more I do this, the more love they make. Look at the difference between the two pans. That's the cheaper brand, which it didn't absorb much. And look how much is left from rusticella. Huge difference. Let's go and try. If you see the two pastas over here, okay, this is my ignorant feedback. Here we have the industrial brand. You can see that the pasta is dying. It's almost dead. Look how dry it is. Instead, you can see this artisan pasta here. It's still alive. It's like telling me, eat me. Can we just share and see the difference?
Yeah, the feel that is the all pasta is maybe cooked well, is al dente. The flavor is only for the sauce, not pasta. You try.
The sauce is just not making love with the pasta yet. The sauce and the pasta are not connected. Yeah. That's what I feel like.
You try this and you see that the sauce is connected with the pasta.
Let's try this one. Yeah, that's a good feel. Let's have it. I basically have the sauce and the pasta connected.
Yeah.
When I eat it, I enjoy both at the same time, which is what we want, right?
This is the reason, the difference between artisanal and industrial, that you taste pasta and sauce together, not only sauce.
So the look is the same.
It's more or less the same. Maybe this is more white, is more brilliant, and this is more dark. But at the end, the taste is, even if you taste the difference between just olive oil, you recognize much better the difference.
Well, just when you come and have a look closely here, come and have a look closely. They've been cooked at the same time. Can you see how dry this is? That's dry. We didn't do anything here. And look at this one. Look at this and look at this. We cooked this a little bit longer because it takes longer. But look. Look at that. Maybe we even cooked this a little bit longer than it should be, should have been, and it's still...
No, but usually if you wait also 2 minutes more, the pasta remains always the same.
Look at that.
It's not a problem.
So the answer is, when you eat pasta, try to eat artisan pasta. It's better for you, better for your belly, and makes you happy.
Yeah.
He's an artisan. Support artisans from all over the world, local and international.
Small category that strong work to increase the quality of our pasta in Italy.
Yes. Guys, here from Italy, from Rusticata d'Abruzzo, we're enjoying our spaghetti. Grazie Gianluigi.
Thank you, Vincenzo.
Please write a comment below and let us know, do you buy Rusticata d'Abruzzo? Or are you going to buy Rusticata d'Abruzzo? Thank you.